Greetings, everyone. It is a joy and a privilege to be able to share with you via the medium of social media. Open your Bible with me to Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 10. Reading from the New International Version. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. Verse 10, but the angel said to them, do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. I begin this presentation with the premise that nobody sets out with the goal of becoming jaded and bitter. When you think of the word joy, what comes to mind? Perhaps happiness, freedom, or love. The long and short of joy, I believe, is to put Jesus first, others second, and you next. It was Mark Twain that wrote, "Grief can take care of itself, but to get the full value of a joy, you must have somebody to divide it with." This Advent season, as we focus on joy, it reminds us of the joy that the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ brought to the world. As we sing the carols, recall the words of one which says, "Come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant, O come ye to Bethlehem." Another one happily says, "Joy to the world, the Lord is come, let earth receive her King." The concept or theme of joy appears more than 650 times in various forms in the Bible. When we read the Christmas story, we find in Luke chapter 1 and verse 14, where Zechariah was told by an angel, "You will have joy and gladness, and many will rejoice at his birth." In Luke chapter 1 and verse 44, John the Baptist leaped for joy in his mother's womb. 3 verses later, Mary rejoiced in God her Savior. And in Luke chapter 2 and verse 10, the angel proclaimed glad tidings of great joy. This year, we are celebrating Christmas under a global pandemic. And for many of us, we may not be feeling in much of a celebratory mood. But still, there is joy in celebrating the birth of the Christ child. Everyone wants a joyous life. As I said at the beginning, nobody sets out with the goal of becoming jaded and bitter. Those who eventually do not want joy. Those who prefer misery are broken, bitterness has taken root, tragedy has derailed them, and disappointment has hardened them. In Hebrews chapter 12, verses 22 and 24, we read, "But you have come to Mount Zion, to the heavenly Jerusalem, the city of the living God. You have come to thousands upon thousands of angels in joyful assembly to the church of the firstborn, whose names are written in heaven. You have come to God, the judge of all men, to the spirits of righteousness men made perfect, of righteous men made perfect, to Jesus, the mediator of a new covenant, and to the sprinkled blood that speaks a better word than the blood of Abel." Joy is equated with strength. A person full of joy is optimistic despite circumstances. In Nehemiah chapter 8 and verse 10, we read, "This day is sacred to our Lord. Do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength." Believers, life tends to drain away our joy. Experience teaches us that reality seldom exceeds expectation. But I am comforted by the words found in Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2, which proclaims that the theme of darkness and despair will not go on forever. It reads, "The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light has dawned." True joy is not of human origin. You cannot make it happen, but you can find joy again. You can receive it as a gift, but you have to seek the giver of joy. The Bible tells us that joy is a side effect of God's Spirit dwelling within us. In Galatians 5:22 and 23, we read, "But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things, there is no law." Even as new protocols go into effect and the new laws are made that are designed to help curb the spread of COVID-19, there is no law against joy. Let us celebrate Jesus this Christmas. Find joy in serving others, even if it's just a phone call to say hello, how are you doing, or to take them some food or a blanket. And take care of yourself. Keep reading God's word. Stay constant in prayer. Eat right. Rest a lot. Drink plenty of water. And whatever you do, keep smiling. Have a great day, everyone.